Alright guys, it's Ghost Wolf, and welcome to Fallout 4. I am a huge fan of the Fallout franchise, I love New Vegas, I love 3. Played a little bit of the first few games, I didn't really actually finish those, but I'm a huge fan of the lore, and I've read up on a ton of the stuff, so I can't wait to play this. One thing before we get started, I'm not even going to ramble on of how much I love the Fallout franchise, you'll hear it as I play, is we need to pick a difficulty mode. So what do we got for choices? Okay, so we've got very easy. Oh no, these death claws are just like rat roaches. Got easy, you know, enemies wearing paper armor. Normal. Hard, where you wear paper armor. Very hard. And survival. Alright, so let's see. Difficulty leveling affects damage and the chance of legendary enemies. Survival level also dramatically slows the rate of healing. Okay, so survival is what I want to play on. I loved hardcore mode in Fallout New Vegas, where it would have you manage your food, water, sleep schedules, stuff like that, where you actually had to worry about actually surviving. And whenever you use stim packs, it's not instantly applying all the health, so you don't get, you know, plus 30 health and now you're suddenly up to 60 or from 30 or whatever. You actually go 31, 32, 33 to slowly refill, so it makes battles much more dramatic. So we're gonna play on the highest difficulty. And before we begin, I need to warn you, I am going to loot a ton. Let's get started. Let me make sure I go back. Also, you can see I've changed my HUD to blue. I like the blue one better. Start a new game, confirm. The green one destroys your eyes after a long time, so a nice calming blue, I find, is my favorite HUD style. And so yeah, I'll be filling you guys in on lore whenever there's lore and stuff, references to older games and whatnot. Hopefully it does a good job of explaining it itself. But yeah, if I miss something lore-wise or whatnot, feel free to throw it down in the comments as long as it's not spoilery. This is a really slow loading screen. There we go. Oh, so psyched. I'm gonna shut up during the opening stuff.
War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war never changes.
Oh, that was such a good intro. It actually explained all the backstory, so I don't have to. More or less. Ah, character creation time.
War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hun.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Okay, so I must have come back from the war, and I'm on the Veterans. Alright, so we're gonna stay as male. And I'm gonna make this really quick as I customize very, very little things, so that way we can get right to the gameplay. Let's see if I can get a fairly good base face so I can start modifying off of that. Ooh, I did like, what was it, number 8? Yeah, there we go, that's not a bad starting face. Alright, let's see what we can change. I don't want to, can I... Alright, hair style. Oh, wow, this is an interesting one. Okay, let's see if they've got any decent male hairstyles. Always played the older games as female because literally there was nothing good for men. Go with the afro. I like the dapper better than 9 to 5. Come on, give me a decent casual kemp. That's not bad. Pompadour. Wait, top knot is actually... How do I... we're not playing Witcher.
I like it. Makes you look younger.
Sure, we'll go with younger. Alright, let's get some hair colors and stuff fixed up, and then we're good to go. Chestnut brown.
Really working for me.
Let's get ourselves a little bit. Oh, no, 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 no. Skin color was fine. Facial hair. Alright, let's see what we got. Oh, I love the variety they've given, finally. Come on. Yes! The curly mustache. I wouldn't be able to take my character seriously. Yeah, you know, I like a little bit of the facial hair. Let's see, what do we got for close? Yeah, he looks a little bit better with a little bit of hair than nothing. Lone Wanderer
like
works.
It accents your chin.
Alright, cool. I think we're good. Extras. Markings, blemish, damages. Nope. And body. Nah, too muscular. Let's go... got the average Joe look. You know. It's the everyman. Came home from war, you know, he sat on the couch a little bit, he's had some potato chips, you know, some beers with the buds. Yep. Alright. Except, and I think we're good. Actually, can I fix his eyebrow type?
What do you think, hon? Roguishly handsome or handsomely roguish?
Let's make him look not Neanderthal.
Oh, looking good.
Okay, her comments are really... Let's see, come on. Make him look not like an idiot.
Yeah, not bad.
I'm here saying I was gonna be quick about it. Alright, that's good. There. Done. Confirm. Oh, sweet, we actually have direct control immediately.
Hey, hon.
Alright, so Nora's our wife. Can I loot the toilet paper? Newspaper, can I loot anything? Alright, let's see. Brand new Mr. Handy, Braxo.
A Braxo for all your cleaning needs.
Oh, awesome. I want to loot everything. Really should, you know, fix that. It's not a good idea to have that open.
Yeah, let Codsworth take care of it.
I have the most boring taste in wall paintings. Apparently a thing for lighthouses in the beach. Nothing I can... Ooh.
No need to get dressed twice. War never changes. Got that right.
And that's my wife's clothes. Obviously not a big dresser.
We really need to get those vacation photos developed.
Pocket watch.
Ah, broken again.
Okay. Just want to see what I can interact with. Teddy bear.
Huh. How'd you get on the floor, Mr. Bear?
Can I pick you up? No.
Can't wait to teach him to ride this. Should get this signed next time we're at the park. The glove's a little big right now, but Sean will grow into it. He'll either be great at spelling or great at smashing blocks together.
Either choice is completely fine.
To think, one day he's gonna learn how to drive.
Aw, let's see him. Aw, little baby Sean. Baby has been entertained. Challenge completed.
Wonder what Sean will grow up to be.
Ah, the year special book from Fallout 3. Wonder when we can start setting our skills. Oh, I have to get through the story. Blast Radius. An exciting new board game that brings friends, family, and nuclear explosions together. First player to make it to a safe distance will survive, the rest will perish. Do you have what it takes? That is like the most morbid child's game. Holy crap. Who's a good little guy? Can't spin it anymore. Alright. Instamash!
Instamash. Fancy lad snack cakes. Blamco mac and cheese. Expires in... never.
Yay, loaded with preservatives.
Ah, good morning, sir. Your coffee.
Good old USA.
Tea, Earl Grey, hot. No.
And today's newspaper just delivered.
Let's see what's in the news.
More of the same.
Okay, well, that was interesting.
How can someone so small drink so much?
Ooh, excuse me, need to get in the fridge. Nuka-Cola!
Nuka-Cola, ice cold. Saddle up Salisbury steak, graded A+. Looks like the milk got delivered.
Let's see. Bread, cranberry juice, cake, 2 boxes.
Oh, sounds like someone made a stink. I shall attend to young Shaw.
Good, I don't have to clean the diapers.
You know, I was nervous at first, but Codsworth's really good with Sean.
Just drink it right off the table.
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies. My favorite.
Oh, so many references!
It's a little early to be drinking.
Drinking, smoking.
Hun.
Anything you know?
Wow, look at you. How'd a girl like me ever get so lucky, huh?
Awesome.
Can't believe it's almost Halloween.
It's Halloween?
Need to finish making Sean's costume.
What's it gonna be?
Don't be. Everyone's gonna love the speech. Can you get that? It's probably that salesman. He comes for you every day.
Something that is unquestionably inescapable. Okay, I'll be over there in a second. Ooh.
Bunch of our old holotape recordings.
Ah, some nice calming music. Alright, let's go answer the door. Do we have a dog?
Never gonna find that dog.
No, our dog ran away? Oh, that's so sad. It's not even the nuclear apocalypse and we already lost a dog.
Good morning. Vault-Tec calling.
Oh, Well, let's be nice. Good morning.
Good morning.
Isn't it? Just look at that sky out there. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... It's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think, if you catch my meaning.
All right.
Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
So that means, like, free?
But there's room for my entire family, right?
Of course, of course. Minus your robot, naturally. In fact, you're already cleared for entrance. It's just a matter of verifying some information. Don't want there to be any holdups in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation.
Yeah, don't want the paperwork to be slowing us down. Sarcastic.
No, I can't wait for the world to end.
That's the Now, let's see.
Ah, okay. So we'll go with ghosts. Actually, how long can we do this? Whatever. Alright, so we're gonna need a lot of strength to loot things. Can I click on the strength? Ah, there we are. A lot of strength for looting. We're gonna need some perception. Let's see, that's weapon accuracy in vats and environmental awareness. Yeah, a little bit endurance. Overall fitness. Yeah, that's good for sprinting, although we're going to be so overburdened. Charisma, charm and convince others. Yeah, we're a sweet talker. We're going to be able to steal all the loot, carry it away, and then convince anybody who has anything of value to just give it to us right away. And let's go with a bunch of int. Because it's always good to have int, all the hacking, high-tech weapons, and, well, crap, points. I remember there being a lot more in the other games. Let's see, one is agility. Well, we're going to be carrying all the loot anyway, so we're not going to be that agile. Luck? Let's see, general good fortune affects the recharge rate of critical hits. Nah, we'll make our own luck. We don't need that. So let's go with that. I think that's a pretty good build.
Wonderful.
Little min-maxy, but fine.
I'm just going to walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey. It's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
It literally was one form.
No price is too high.
Aww.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Aww.
Sir, Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
All right. One side, Codsworth.
I heard Codsworth. Go on.
Sir, if I may, Sean...
Yes, I'm going! Stop hassling me, robot. Yay. Who's not a stinky baby anymore?
How's the most important man in my life doing? Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that.
Yeah, look at little rocket ships.
Hey, how's my little guy? Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Yeah. Sounds like fun.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
Sir, Mom, you should come and see this.
Codsworth, what's wrong?
Oh, God, that doesn't sound good. Where's my run key?
Yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes, sounds of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation.
We
seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations.
Time to go now.
What's going on?
Glad I filled that paperwork out just a minute ago. Hopefully they processed
reports,
it.
I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York.
Yep, time to go. We're near Boston.
my God.
Let's move. Honey, come on. Grab the baby.
Oh my God.
We need to get to the vault.
All right, come on. Where's the Vault Tech guy?
Residents of Sanctuary Hills. Yeah. If you are registered,
okay, run with the crowd. That's usually a bad idea. Loot it! No.
Hold on to Sean.
Keep him safe.
Just help me pack it up.
Leave it and go. Wait, is the vault literally right behind my house? We have the best housing area ever. Huh?
If you're in the program, step forward. Otherwise, return home.
Hey there.
This is it.
We need to get in.
We're on the list. They just handed it in. Probably that guy that you just made run away.
Adult female. Okay, go ahead.
Come on. Go, go, go.
You two, follow me. Come on.
What's going to happen to all those people outside the gate?
Well, they're going to get burned to ash, probably. Or irradiate and turn into ghouls.
Step on the platform in the center.
Honey, pick up the pace. Come on, go, go, push, go.
Hunt.
Keep
just
going.
A little farther.
Go, 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 go.
All right, that's it. Send it down.
Almost there. We're going to be okay. I love you. Both of you.
We love you too.
Oh my God. Oh. Well, I'm glad we signed the paperwork just like a minute ago.
Hold on.
Oh shit, here comes the shockwave. Well, all those people up there are dead. And all the power's out in the vault.
We did it. We made it.
Hey.
What? You're okay.
What's going on?
We got bombed.
Everyone, please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks.
Oh.
We'll get everyone situated in your new home.
Talking to all the new neighbors.
Vault hey there.
111.
Elevator.
A better future. Whoa. Underground.
So we just.
It beat out a nuclear explosion. Stop bitching.
If we left a minute later.
No.
We'd all
don't
be.
Get caught up thinking about that.
True, true. We made it by a minute.
Everybody,
I signed my paperwork this morning.
And through the door there.
Excuse me.
Up the stairs.
Oh, our overseer.
Just head up the stairs.
I'm gonna bug you.
I'm
gonna bug you.
Head inside. Just up the stairs there.
Proceed in an orderly fashion.
Welcome to your new home.
Excuse me.
Right up the stairs and through that large gear-shaped door.
Hey there.
Fine. As soon as the world stops spinning. I'm sorry.
All right, new neighbors are all panicky.
We made it. This is our new home.
Well, we have the baby. You little Sean. Are you... He's asleep. Sean has officially slept through a nuclear bomb dropping. Without crying, by the way. Very well-behaved baby. Come on. Come on, hon. Up the stairs.
Excuse
morning,
me.
Sir.
Hello there.
Welcome.
Once we seal the vault, we'll all be getting to know each other a lot more, I'm sure.
Okay.
You need to concern yourself with these door controls. That's my job. You just relax.
I push the red button. Oh, okay, so there's a vault, an elevator, and then another vault door. I like the double protection. Well, it seems like they've got a lot of piping, and they're still... That's actually in the way of the door. That might be a concern.
Good.
What is this, like, airport security?
You
need a pat down?
Take a seat. Just step over to the table.
I don't have any loot yet.
Looks fine.
Can the baby have that radiation? I swear, if you mess with my son.
Hey.
Welcome to Vault 111.
Hey, hon.
I'm sure you'll feel
you
right
gotta
at
take
home
your suit?
No.
Ooh, loot.
It's
yes, please.
It's down the hallway right
thanks.
There.
What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
See?
When do I get my Pip-Boy?
This is our new home.
Oh, you're gonna love it.
Down that hallway?
This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you.
Awesome. I mean, it looks fancier. It's not all rust colored, but then again, it's pre-war.
Everything we had.
My mother and father died in DC.
Move along.
Oh God, honey. What if they didn't make it? I know this.
DC got nuked hard. That was Fallout 3.
Every step of the way, you'll thrive here.
Did you have any family outside the city?
Oh God.
Oh God. We'll never see them again.
Yeah, anyone who didn't live, like, right down the road from this vault got blown to bits.
Hey there.
I'll be sure to sit down with all of you about adjusting to vault life. For now, just follow your guide.
This is kinda awesome.
We didn't even bring any luggage. Oh, my clothes. God, can you believe it? First thing I miss are my damn suits.
Yep, don't care a thing about all your family.
My mother, my father. There's no way they made it.
Hey, we got free clothes,
hey,
though.
Hon.
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Oh, we'll be going over all that
this
in orientation.
This is our new home.
Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
Nothing to see here.
Wow, okay.
It's gonna be okay, right?
Yep, we're just gonna live the rest of our lives underground.
It's a good fit. Just checking everyone off the list as they come in.
Fashionable as well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Sir, that's a special form. That's not a list of people. You sure you're qualified?
A lot of names to process. I'm glad so many people made it.
There are no names. Ooh.
Excuse me.
Just follow your guy.
Can I hack the computer? Fine.
Such a lovely family you have. I hope you'll see this as your new home.
Hey.
Just follow your guide. He'll get you all situated.
Interesting. Like one of those new massager chairs? We're getting launched into space? No, there's no hatches on top. Interesting.
Excuse
hey.
Me.
Guess we're some of the lucky ones, right?
Phew. Go on. Nothing to worry
about. Hey, I came down with the blast. I got to see it and everything.
Hey there.
I can't stop shaking.
Hey there.
Just step in here and
we
put
made
your
it.
Vault suit on.
Aww. Little Sean.
Who's my little guy? I'm not going far. I'll just be over there.
You slept through a nuclear bomb going off.
There he is. See?
Yeah.
Daddy's not going far.
All set? Just step inside and put on your vault suit.
Like, out here in the hallway? In front of all these ladies? Gonna get naked? Is that what's happening here? Ah, decontamination pod. Okay, so it's guessing... Oh yeah, we were directly exposed to all that radiation.
Hey there.
Just step into the chamber.
Excuse me.
Vault Tech is here for you.
Yes, follow the guide.
There's a nuke. A goddamn nuke.
Mm-hmm. Glad you know what a giant glowing bomb on the horizon means. Okay, well, we're obviously the smartest person in this vault. And we apparently just instantly got dressed in front of everybody.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the vault.
Is that safe to be depressurized with a baby? Doesn't Sean get his own pod?
Resident secure.
Hey, honey.
Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete.
Oh, that was easy.
Thought it was... five,
wait, that's ice. Oh, it's a cryopod. They lied to us.
One.
I was like, I was going to expect some mist to decontaminate us, but no, they froze us. So that's the one thing about all Vault Tech vaults. They're all experiments. Should have known this one wouldn't have been any different. And now we exit to the wasteland. Is she okay? Sean okay? Hopefully there wasn't like a failure. Is there a release?
Open it.
I don't like this. Why is your name Mysterious Figure?
No. I'm okay. Almost. Everything's gonna be fine.
Come. No, I've got him.
Let the boy go.
Whoa, bitch. Put the gun down. Break open this damn case.
God.
You just shot my wife. just took my kid. I know your face. I see your scar. I'm gonna kill you. Still have a backup. They just looted my son. I'm the only one allowed to do looting. I was gonna teach my son how to carry stuff and scrounge around in refrigerators. Yeah, you're dead. You are totally dead. As soon as I get out of here, I'm coming after you. Oh, critical failure. Lovely. Ugh.
Come on! There has to be a release!
Oh. Right next to the door.
Come on, come on, come on!
Open!
Oh, God!
A little panicky for being frozen. We know she's dead. Yeah, she kinda got shot.
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back.
Although, technically, she was frozen again immediately after being shot, so if I actually reseal this... There may be some medical technology in the wasteland that can save her. Except everything is failing. Right.
God. Why would Vault do this?
Because they're evil and they like experimenting on people. And they apparently build really shitty cryopods.
Hello? Anyone?
Really? None of them? Okay, so the manual release override's kind of your safety feature. And what? We had 6 out of 7 fail? Ooh, yes, let's see what's on the computer. Alright, backstory. Cryogenic lay offline, premature terminalization, resulting in system failure, isolated manual remote overrides detected, controls disabled. Alright. Life support. Offline. That is not good. Pod occupation status. C6 was Norrin, Sean, C7 was me. Mr. Russell, C1 was empty. Mrs. Callahan, Mr. Callahan, Mrs. and Mr. Abel, Mr. Russell. C7, C6. Alright, I'm gonna remember that. I still remember the first Fallout where you had to pay attention to the numbers and stuff in the very beginning of the game, because it came in handy later. C6 and C7. I kinda don't care about the evacuation. Let's open for some more information on that computer. Alright, let's get out of here. Anything to loot on the way? I can get to go in here! Nice. What do we got in here? Oh! Okay, it started. Nice new jumpsuit. The loot has been added. Oh, wow, even more people are in here. Okay, seriously, whoever made these needs to be fired.
Oh, God.
Yeah, everyone's kind of dead. It's not generally a good sign for a vault. This is a pretty small vault, too. I guess it was designed to have everyone in cryo sleep. Man, that's shoddy construction. All right, what's this terminal tell us? Can we find out anything about what's going on? What year it is? No, same message as the other one. Same message as the other one. Mr. DiPedio, Cindy Coffrin, Mr. Whitfield. Oh, that's interesting. They didn't put the families together on this one. Unless they're across from each other. Where's the numbers on these pods? That doesn't help at all. Oh, stop your heavy breathing. Ooh, I like that. We can actually loot objects that are inside containers now without having to open the whole thing up. Really? Malfunctioning the emergency exit door override? Opening this door will deregulate the temp and atmosphere to suboptimal levels. Oh, that's why we're freezing. It's all super cool in here because we're cryo-frozen. Ah. Let's get to where it's warmer. Oh, and rad roaches. Hooray. Oh, lots of rad roaches. Joy. Oh, we got a weapon. Ha! Alright. Before we go that way, anything to loot in here? Nuka-Cola, pencil. Yes, I'll take all of it. Three more money, done. Stimpak, yes please. Packet of cigarettes and cigarette, done. Clipboards, sure, I'll take everything. Oh, I wanted to take the chair, not sit in the chair. Alright, we had a nice little sit, we've rested, calmed down a little bit. Ooh, security terminal. Alright, tell us what's going on. Security instructions. Confidential. Vault is designed to test long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects. Dicks. Could have told us about it. I'd have still gone in. Security staff are responsible for maintaining the installation integrity and monitoring science staff activity. No circumstances are staff allowed to deviate from assigned duties. Insubordination or interference with the vault operations or capital offenses are to use lethal force. Wow. So if no one agrees, kill them. Operations protocol. Alright, resident admissions. Upon activation notice, personnel required to report to the entry area and assist with admittance of vault residents. Maintain order and ensure that no personnel or residents attempt to evacuate the vault. Research staff will be responsible for residents' intake and escort each to the designated cryogenic pod. Residents not accounted for in the manifest should be asked to step aside and detained forcibly by security if necessary. Once all residents have been sealed into the preservation chambers, dispose of any detainees. Wow, just go kill everybody else. Vault entryway must remain sealed under any circumstances. All clear and evacuation. All clear message. Following a nuclear event, Vault Tech will monitor hazards such as radiation level, enemy invasion, subsequent attack, and other factors. Once conditions are deemed safe, Terminal will receive an all clear notice. Okay. Upon receiving the all clear notice, Vault Tech personnel will be evacuated at Overseer's discretion, so the Overseer can keep you in the Vault. Disregard any notices from organizations or individuals not associated with Vault Tech, including government and military. Wow. Like, Vault Tech was just taking over. I mean, admittedly, if you have most of the majority of the remaining residents of the world, you know, why not put yourself into a position of power? Residents are not to be disrupted or evacuated. Vault Tech will attend to their needs remotely once Vault 11 staff have been evacuated. Mandatory shelter period. Vault 111 is classified as short-term assignment. Non-resident personnel are expected to carry out research duties and basic maintenance. Overseer may elect to evacuate staff after a mandatory period of... Just 6 months? Really? No circumstances may Vault 11 staff evacuate during the shelter period unless receiving the all-clear message. It takes a lot more than just 6 months to get out of a nuclear fallout zone. Hopefully they plan for enough food for a longer period. Staff duty. Science staff. There's a research team, must daily monitor vital signs, cardiopulmonary and cognitive ability in particular must be recorded hourly. Life-saving intervention is only permitted if greater than 80% of the resident population has perished while in cryogenic suspension. Wow. Well, because everything is faulty except for two of the doors, I think more than 80% did die. Independent research is encouraged and left to oversee discretion. Alright, so that's what the science staff are doing. Security staff, patrols, 8-hour rotation, monitoring for signs of intrusion, checking for atmospheric leaks. At least they're doing something useful. Settling disputes, enforcement of regulations by the Overseer, and Vault-Tec. And maintenance. Due to nature of Vault, personnel will be expected to perform duties outside their normal qualifications, such as janitorial duties and food prep. So sorry, scientists, have them up. And the Overseer gets to decide. Oh boy, I bet that's fun. Alright, well, I think that's everything from that. Oh no. Okay, Operation Protocol Manual. No, I just read that. Security logs. Alright, let's see what happened. So, 2077 was the year we got frozen in here, right before Halloween. Aw, we missed out on Halloween. Finally happened, the world's over, barely all the, got all the residents inside, not everyone made it. Now it's just us and the icebergs, I don't get it. Eggheads tried to explain to me that keeping them frozen is a big experiment for a better future or something. Yeah, that's what all the Vault-Tec vaults say, is it's all for a better future. I don't know, it just doesn't seem right before... that we were smiling at them all the time before putting them on ice. Shouldn't we have told them or something? Nope, because that's how Vault-Tec rolls. Christmas Underground. Got together with the rest of security boys and support staff, and we had a little party. Best gift that got handed out was a fancy lead snack cake that wasn't too stale. None of the scientists came. Overseer wasn't there either. I just don't get them. They hiding something from us, another company secret only for higher-ups. Ooh, So maybe not everyone got the same messages. This is a security thing, so maybe the scientists have something on their computer? I'll have to look out for more terminals. Alright, just a few more months till the all-clear is supposed to come through, then we can start rebuilding. Not after 6 months. That's not how nuclear fallout works. Only a few weeks left in our mandatory shelter period, everyone's getting stir-crazy. Some people are even saying the all-clear signal is never coming. Can't stay here much longer, that's for sure. It's not the fact that I've been staring at the same break room and bunk bed for over 6 months. You only have a few food enough for another few months, tops. And that's the problem with planning. 6 months is not good when a bomb detonates within viewing range of the vault. The Overseer keeps telling everybody to be patient, focus on work, definitely keeping us out of the loop. Something bad is going on, I just know it. Uh-oh. I think stuff's starting to go shit. Main door accessing the vault exit is malfunctioning. Now the only way out is through the Overseer's evacuation tunnel. How convenient for him. He has one of the science team watching the door into his office at all times from a little makeshift checkpoint. Got invited to a meeting tonight. Support staffers and security only. Sounds like I'm not the only one with an axe to grind. Oh. So support and security had a revolt, maybe? Against the science guys and the Overseer? Oh, last entry. I'm all clear from Vault Tech is coming. We need to leave. We're all but out of food. Almost murdered Stanley for dropping a damn salt cracker on the floor. Wow. Anvilus confronted the Overseer about opening up the vault. Never knew the man that small could shout that loud. Now he's locked himself in his office along with the rest of the science staff. We're supposed to hand over any food, weapons, and medicine by tonight, or there's going to be consequences. I've talked to everyone. It's time. One way or another, we're getting out of this vault. Oh boy. Well, nothing like a good old-fashioned mutiny. Alright, well, we learned a bit from that. That water scared me. Hey, I missed a coffee cup. My looting is failing. Well, I did get it eventually, so I guess my loot's not failing. Anything else? Alright. Can I... How do I... There's my baton. Oh, we have apparently been here for a while, because that looks like a normal vault. It's actually a really well-intact vault, considering. I don't know how many years I've been out, so it was 2077 when we left. Or when we got frozen. Hello, Mr. Radroach. Come on. Come on, you little son of a bitch. Ah! It just gave me... When it hit me, it gave me radiation?
Giant.
Okay, well, there's my health bar.
Roaches? What the hell?
Welcome to the wasteland. Ooh, another baton. More coffee mugs. Water fountain. Heal up. Heal up faster. Oh! Oh, there we go. So I've got a tiny bit of my health missing. Like a very, very small sliver. I wonder if radiation's different in this game. Alright, now this is the room. Yeah, that has all the roaches. Let's not go in there yet. Coffee cups! More roaches. Clear the place first. Roaches, you in here? No. Alright, let's see if we can find anything at all to loot. Or tell us what happened here. Anything in the boxes? Beds? Chairs? It's a very boring vault. No wonder they went crazy. I mean, this room is not up to Vault Tech standards. Coffee cup. Ooh, beer. Coffee. Beer, beer. Nothing in those. Beer, beer, beer. Take all your money. Hot plate. Toaster. Yes, I'm carrying a toaster out of the vault. Hey, I can crouch. Nothing in there. Anything in the fridge? Nope. Alright, let's see what's on our terminal. Recreational terminal. Alright, Overseer memo. Remember, use of recreational terminal is a privilege. Its work performance declines. This privilege may be revoked. Alright. Top 10. I wonder if this is the developers putting their names in the high score list. So, play tape. Red Menace! Awesome! So it's like a game within a game? Alright, start. It's freaking Donkey Kong! Oh, that's awesome. Oh yeah, let's play some Donkey Kong. Oh, this is a classic Donkey Kong. Oop, oop, oop. they gonna throw barrels at me? This is kind of weird. Alright, this is probably the hammer. Oh, you can't climb with the... or jump with the le... aww. Yeah! Retro arcade skills, go! Dun-dun-dun-dun! Level one cleared. Oh, wow, they haven't have all the levels. Like, oh my gosh, I remember all of these. Oh, oh, okay. Let's go this way. Nope, the ladder's down. Come on. Oh, okay, I have to really make a break for this one. Shit. Aha! Screw you, Red Menace, Donkey Kong. I'm just gonna go until I die once. Oh, I remember this level. Oop. Shit. Yeah! All I gotta do is just knock out all these supports. And victory! We win! And now it just keeps getting harder, but repeating the same levels. Alright, I'll play more later. Yeah, so let's quit the game. Can I... oh, eject the holotape. Nice! Now I can take it with me. Oh, that's a nice touch. Wow, this is a shitty shower. Is there a door here? Oh, okay. At least there's some privacy. Alright, let's keep going. More loot should be ahead. Oh. Well, thank you very much, little roach, to let me know that that is not a place I want to walk. Let's just go around the outside. Hey, Rad Roach. Sneak attack critical! Bam! Ow, did you just spit at me? I didn't know they could spit.
What happened here? Where is everyone?
I'll make a break for it. Ah, got it! Is there any loot down there? Someone's dumb enough to run down into the... no, there's no loot. Hey, more Rad Roaches. Oh, spit it! Whoa! Yes! Spit attacks this time. Alright, I'm damaged. Ah, water fountain. Come on, drink faster. Ow. Oh, this might... it might be because I'm on survival. Things don't, heal very quickly. Rad Roach is in the room. I don't have a terribly high perception, so I don't really have a huge notice area. Nope. But we've got 10mm rounds. Ooh, pistol. I will take that. Nothing in the file cabinet. Cryolator case. Unlock master.
Nice. Coming back later for you.
Hell yeah. I don't know what that gun does, but it's a named gun, so it must be good. Preserve cigarette pack. Got his own private bathroom. Ooh, ammo. I like how you don't have to go into a menu to loot things anymore. This is gonna make this playthrough a lot faster for you guys. Maybe. Ooh, bobby pins.
Loctite. Oh, it's
mat lock is too difficult. All right.
Is this all that's left?
Well, he's dead. Overseer's terminal. Ooh, another pistol. Glasses! Some stim packs. 30% of your max health. Ooh, that's actually pretty good. Thing hiding down in the drawers. No? Alright, let's see what's happening in the vault. This terminal should tell us everything. Overseer instructions. Dissect long-term effects of animation on aware humans. Staff will be on short-term assignment to monitor basic long-term assignment will be handled remotely by Vault Tech technicians. Oh, so the staff was only here to put the people in and do the initial testing, and then everything was going to be by computer. Under no circumstances is suspension to be disrupted. This includes the administration life-saving measures. Your staff is also considered expendable. So anyone in here was just allowed to die. And you can kill the staff if there's attempts to evacuate prematurely. Unused cryogenic pods are the preferred method for cadaver disposal. Wow. Ah, cryolator. This tells me what it is. Long dream to make a cryogenic freezing technology available in a portable, on-demand form. I get a freeze gun? Awesome, coming back for that. Thankfully, no short supply of the chemicals and components I need to tinker with the prototype. It's all a nice way to occupy the time until we have all clear signal. Operation Protocol Manual. Is this all the same? Staff duties. Wondering if he sees anything different. Nope, looks like all those are the same. All clear in evacuation. Does he know anything different? No. Okay. Overseer's log. Preparations. Final staff orientation is complete, but all but a few residents down in the Sanctuary Hills have been enrolled, and several from Concord as well. Vault-Tec supervisors came up this week to do a technical review. Vault is ready to open. I can only imagine what wonders our residents will get to witness. The notion of leaping forward in time. Almost wish I could join them and see the promise of our future realized. At least they had good intentions, or he did. October 23rd. Alright, first day. We were lucky that most of the staff was nearby when the early warnings came through. We had less notice than expected, but only Nordhagen was missing when we sealed the entrance. So we'll probably find him dead outside. Resident admittance went smoothly, everyone made it, and the family that waited until the last minute. Oh, that was us. I was worried there would be more suspicion, but things happened so fast for these people, they must have been too overwhelmed to question the cryogenic pods. Yeah, I didn't really question them too much. I thought they were a bit suspicious, but... yeah. Systems malfunction. Strange issues today with pod C3. Subject appears to be having heart palpitations. Nothing like threatening, but unusual. Realized almost too late the pod was malfunctioning. Cryogenic array almost started thawing her out. Okay, hiccup in Vault Tech's override system. So we were C6 and C7, so that wasn't us. Suspect a hiccup in Vault Tech's remote override systems may have sent an errant signal. We'll have to keep an eye out, hope the systems are reliable once we evacuate the staff. Oh, at least this overseer actually cared. Supplies running low. But no all clear signal yet, even though we're nearing the end of the 180-day mandatory shelter period. Supplies were never intended to last much longer than that, and despite my best efforts, people are beginning to question what we're doing here. People think we can just leave the 180 days up there insane. Thank you! Radioactive exposure would still be potent enough to fry everyone if the vault seals are breached that early. Whole point of the all-clear was to receive additional instructions from the main office. I don't know what to do. I can't open the vault. I can't expect our supplies to last forever. Have to keep everything under control until the all-clear. Be interesting if it would let me know that enter was let me see the rest of the message. Or, you know, I could just scroll like every other message. Mutiny! Faction led by security personnel have turned on me, demanding that they be allowed to leave the vault. Idiots. I'll not open the door to be irradiated to death out there. I'm consolidating the remaining supplies, putting the staff on lockdown. We're going to have start prioritizing who deserves what little food we have left. Been too generous with the rations. If people don't like it, well, that's fewer mouths to feed. Wow. Well, he was nice at the start. And open the evacuation tunnel. Now open, remind all staff to be orderly and following shutdown protocols before exit and resealing the vault. Please maintain all staff records and research. Report to your local Vault-Tec supervisors for debriefing and further instructions. Alright. Now we got a gun. Oh sweet, we can actually do this third-person shootery. Nice. Dun dun dun. I'm gonna try this out for a bit. Sneak attack critical! Boom! Headshot. Nice try. Okay, so my aim at longer range sucks. Get closer, get closer. Bam. Ah, nice. Oh, oh. Thought I heard more skittering. One and two. It's kind of weird being in third person. I think I'll stick to first person for a bit. Oh, there was one more of you. Bastard. Oh, I should probably have tried out Vats. I think I hear one more up there. So yeah, I'm not a huge fan of Vats. I like playing kind of more FPS style and not zooming in. Oh, what did I just do? Oh, my inventory. All right, so I got the 10mm pistols. 10mm rounds, just a little wrench. We have collected a lot of stuff. Eyeglasses. No, I don't want to put the eyeglasses on the Rad Roach. I want to equip them. And we've got two wedding rings. Oh, I didn't realize I took my wedding ring off my wife. Oh, what a nice little thought. All right, well, I've got some Rad Roach meat. Guy. Pop. Anyone else want a piece of this? Nope. Shit, I was gonna use Vats. Ah, I'm sorry. I'm not used to using Vats much. I just wanted to see what the new Vats looks like. Ooh, hotkeys. Form melee attacks while... Oh, I don't want to use a stim pack. Four? Three. Oh, okay, so I've got hotkeys. Melee attack. Ooh, sweet, I can pistol whip. That's nice. Whole other section of the vault? No, that's where we came from. Now it opens? Right? Yeah, this is just back to my wife. Weird. I guess it's so I don't have to walk around now that I'm done with the tutorial bit. Can I loot things? Alive? Yes.
Did anyone get out?
More ammo. Ooh, new vault check jumpsuit. Awesome, awesome. Oh, shit. Scared the hell out of me. I could have used Vats again. Ugh.
Am I the only one left?
I figured it'll be like a lot more high action packed with as dangerous of enemies as we have and no Vats. Oh, sweet, a Pip-Boy. Maybe now I can actually access my inventory and put some stuff on. Sort out this weapon wheel. Nice, nice. Oh, that looks pretty awesome. And again, I like the blue. 64K RAM, that's it? Wow. Alright. There's my strength. I'm already halfway to the next level. Only lost 1 HP. No perks. Inventories. Weapons. Apparel. Aha! Put some eyeglasses on. Gets me bonus perception. New jumpsuit is the same as the old. Got our wedding rings. Can I equip them both? Wearing my wife's. Wearing mine. Some Rad Roach meat. Gives me 15 seconds of HP regen, but 11 rads. Bobby pin, Red Menace. Oh, sweet. That's kind of cool. I don't want to play. No. Quit. All of the junk I picked up. Like, I was just all under junk. Oh, and it even tells... Okay, so there's a crafting system, and it tells us what resources everything gives. Awesome. Mods, ammo... Exit the vault. Alright, that's our mission. Workshops, stats. Oh, wow. This is a big, big map. So this is the Boston area. Ooh! Okay, so I recognize this. This is the main river that runs through Boston. I lived in Boston for a summer, actually. I used to work at the Boston General Hospital that was down over here. I took the train... Kind of followed over around here, and I lived... Here's Harvard campus over here, so I lived probably... There's the river walkway here. So maybe I'll actually see my old apartment building. That would be freaky. And no radio signals. Ooh, perk chart. Aha, so here's all of our perks. So I can assign perks, maybe? No? How do I scroll around on the map? There we are. Alright, cool. Awesome! Okay, where do I go from here? Ah. Oh, I gotta open the vault. It's under the controls that he said I wouldn't touch. I'm touching the red button now, you can't stop me. Or I'm plugging the Pip-Boy into the access slot. Now I'm pushing the red button.
Vault door cycling sequence initiated. Please stand back.
Oh, I love watching the vault doors open. This one's actually a really cool lock. And then we get to go to the wasteland. That is so awesome. Oh. Probably shouldn't have jumped down if the bridge was just gonna auto-extend. This water irradiated? Yep, that water's irradiated. Why did I drink that? That was like the worst way to test. Any hidden loots? No? Come on, there's gotta be one hidden loot for the one idiot like me who jumps down here. Huh? One piece of loot? I'll take anything. Wrench? No? Alright. Oh. Turn the light off. Come on. Oh, speaking of light, can I get my Pip-Boy light? Yes! So this is one of the reasons why I always liked the screen to be blue, because it gives a better light. If you go green, it's actually a really bad illumination. And the blue's not hard on your eyes. Alright, there's gotta be something in here. I know I'm holding up going into the wasteland, but just want some loot. Alright. Oh, for your safety, do you want to change anything? Change name, special attributes, change appearance, finish, exit the vault. I'm actually happy with name, special attributes. So off into the wasteland I go. To loot everything, and eventually re-loot my son.
Enjoy your return.
And then teach my son how to loot. Skull to play next to many of his aims means they're several levels higher than you and may be difficult to defeat in combat. In such cases, running away and returning when you're stronger may be the wisest course of action. Good to know, and we're playing on the highest difficulty level, so we're probably going to see that a lot. Oh, the sun is bright. God, that hurts my eyes. I've been playing in a dark room. Well, birds exist. Oh my god, my eyes. Stop staring into the sun. Oh, there we go. Now it's cleaning, clearing up. My eyes have adjusted. So that is the wasteland. Well, we'll get headed on our adventure in the next episode. So we'll see you next time. And let me know if you guys are enjoying the series. You know, throw a like down or throw a comment saying if you want more. Planning on doing, like, hour-long episodes, and I plan on exploring everything in the wasteland. I mean, I'm sure a few quests are going to be locked off by moral choices, or which story path I pick that's good or evil or whatnot. But I plan on doing a ton of crafting, ton of looting, so let me know. We'll see you next time.